or a hustled dress that profiteers from the resolves and endeavors of the British Canadian, U.S. Force and Surveillance, Merchant Navy Service, the RAF pilots and crews, the combined and allied forces, to continue getting the Trinity across the Atlantic, from Britain to Britain, and surely Britain and Britain to complete Nazi Germany. Bismarck on the 24th of May 1941 sunk HMS Hood with a loss of 1,419 sailors. On the 27th of May 1941, 3 days later, HMS King George V and HMS Rodney in a 1-hour-long attack on Bismarck incapacitated her, and the HMS Dorsetshire hit her with 3 torpedoes and sank her. The rest of the German battleships were ordered back to London. This dramatically reduced the service attacks on merchant shipping on the western approaches. German strategy in the Atlantic was more led to the U-boats operating in Wolfgang. Secondly, HMS Bulldog in 1941 salvaged a complete set of the cipher boats and an English machine called U-boat 110 after the crew abandoned it. The U-boat then was left to sink. The crew breakers and petrol craft were soon able to decipher the messages and informed the Royal Navy and RAF of the U-boat patrol position. During the summer and autumn of 1941, the RAF were able to divert convoys away from the danger of U-boats and shipwrecks. However, the Germans became aware of this and changed their initial machines, and the U-boats continued in 1942 to ravage a significant amount of merchant ships crossing the Atlantic. Thirdly, in February 1942, the Germans switched the U-boats to a new network called Pier. This was used. This also used the four rotors on the ship, enabling communication with U-boats. In October 1942, the crew of HMS Picard salvaged an Enigma machine and material for a U-boat 599 as she found it. Alexei Clark managed to break the new cycle of Enigma coded messages to U-boats by December 1942, and the RN and the RAF were made aware of U-boat patrol positions once again. In 1943, shipping losses declined dramatically as U-boat numbers reduced. 519 U-boats were sunk by British Canadian nuclear forces, including the RAF, 175 sunk by the American forces, and 50 by the Soviets. 73 were struggling in the 18,000 German submarines lost their lives. The Royal and Commonwealth Forces Navy lost 36 ships. The US and Allied Forces Navy I haven't noticed anybody in the RAF throughout the war, Corporal Command worked tirelessly with the Royal Navy to using anti-submarine aircraft. This is one aircraft available to take the fight to U-boats. The RAF destroyed 212 U-boats. This included dogfights and German aircraft attacking merchant shipping. We must never forget that our gallant men who lost their lives in the World War III gave their tomorrows for our today. tune in the early evening. The convoys acted as guides and but had protection across the entire North Atlantic with the large central area unprotected. On March the 6th, 1941, British Prime Minister Winston Churchill used the phrase Battle of the Atlantic to emphasize its importance of the nation's survival. Things changed during 1941 and 42, with the United States now entering the war with its vast manufacturing capability in America. Shipbuilding increased to such an extent that the new vessels began to outrun the world. As already mentioned, the protection of the convoy was greatly improved by information obtained by the court papers of the press supply. In May 1943, the tide of the war began to shift in favor of the Allies. Merchant Navy Allied ships lost in the Battle of the Atlantic were 1939-47, 1940-349, 1941-496, 1942-1006, 1943-284, 1944-31, 1945-19. These total 2,232 ships. The vast majority were British, with 30,000 Merchant Navy dead. The figures indicate that by May 1943, the losses had substantially reduced and the tide had turned. Many vessels successfully made the North Atlantic crossing, only to be sunk in British waters, while others suffered the same fate before joining the outward-bound Atlantic convoy. Without the great sacrifice and hardships endured by the seafarers of the Merchant Navy, Royal Navy, to support from the RAF, the UK would not be able to prosecute the war without the crucial supplies needed to keep and defend the UK troops that year. And the outcome of the war would have been much different. Great debt, war, thank you. called Flowers of the Forest. To your forbearance, that is where it is called Pier location. There's two more stages to go. This next one is because you all know you're in the war, it was up to start the man's work in the street to attend the end of the election. The one thing to say, the different phases of the war, I Service, the Merchant Navy.